Even now, after the tragedy befallen us still stings, I search my memories for clues. I should have been more thorough in striving to uncover the secrets, root out the lies, and expose the deception of those who conspired against me. If only I could go back in time, back to the first time I met the woman in white. The fading summer left me out of health, out of spirits, and, if truth be told, out of money as well. I found employment as an art tutor to two young ladies of the wealthy Fairlie family. As luck would have it, my train broke down, and I had to walk from the station to Limeridge House by the light of the moon.
Is that the way to London?
Oh.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to frighten you. I need to know. You don't suspect me of any wrong, do you?
Of course not. The hour is late, and it may be difficult to travel there by cab.
And where are you headed? Away from London?
North, to Cumberland, to Limeridge House.
I was once very happy at Limeridge House. Do you know a baronet?
She's gone. How strange. Almost as if she was running from something. Or someone. Ah, Limeridge House at last. It's now dawn, but I don't want to wake the servants. I'll have to find my own way into the house. Heard that Lord Fairlie is quite an eccentric old codger. He's installed puzzling devices to keep strangers away. He values his privacy.
You must be Walter, our art tutor. We've been expecting you. I am Marion. You'll be teaching art lessons to me and my sister Laura. Laura is not feeling well and is confined to her room for the day. My uncle, Lord Fairlie, wishes to see you at once. He is an impatient old man. I've no idea, Mr. Hartright. I have to travel to London this morning, but I will search through my late mother's letters this afternoon to see if we can find anything. I'm sorry to leave you so suddenly. Please feel at home. You'll find door keys lying about. My uncle resides in the study. I'm so glad you're finally here. Pettigrew has told us so much about you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.